We're down near Dodge Center, Minnesota at Roger Toquam's field. Out here today, we're installing a denitrifying bioreactor. Bioreactors and other edge of field denitrifying practices are important because much of the land in the Midwest where we produce much of the corn and soybeans is drained, meaning that it has too tight of soils. They're not permeable enough to get rid of the water, and that inhibits crop growth. So we drain them. But at the same time, that results in a flow of nutrients via fertilizers to our surface waters. And these practices, denitrifying bioreactors and saturated buffers, take out that nitrogen before it gets to our streams, rivers, and lakes and causes additional problems in the environment. That fertilizer, once it gets off the fields and into that drainage water out into our rivers and lakes, it spawns algal blooms, which create problems for recreational activities, water treatment, and ultimately makes it down to the Gulf of Mexico where it can cause issues down there as well. So we install these bioreactors to remove some of those nutrients before they get off the field and out into that broader environment. Typically, we need to find where the main tile line is flowing, and then we intersect that and we divert some of the water from that main tile line into a trench that we fill with wood chips. And in the process of the water flowing through those wood chips, the nutrients, nitrate, gets degraded before it flows out into our streams. So the first step to installing a bioreactor is to figure out where the tile is outletting, where it flows out of the field at.
There's a number of steps in this process. The first is finding a place. The footprint here is 20 feet by 80 feet, plus there are some control structures. But you basically need to be at a location somewhere between the field and the ditch. And then having adequate amount of water coming through so it can treat a sufficient amount of water. And then we begin construction. And the construction is the removal of the soil, in this case, 4 feet deep, and then we're replacing that with wood chips.
The survey equipment is my instrument that I use to make sure that the elevations are correct. It's connected to satellites, so it's constantly pinging my exact location. They need to make sure that the grade is correct, so when the water, because we are putting tile in, it needs to flow at the right grade to make sure that it's not gonna be standing and it's gonna flow where it's supposed to be going. So once the soil has been excavated and made sure that the elevations are correct, we put in the plastic liner, we lay it out, and then we overlap it along the sides and then staple it down so when we're putting the wood chips in, it's not folding back in, but we overlap in the center of the bed so no water is seeping or wood chips are being eroded by the soil. We need a barrier between the soil and the wood chips because we don't want soil coming in and filling in the spaces of the wood chips because that will reduce the ability to filter out the nitrates.
There's a plastic liner, and that's just to stop water from seeping into the sides of the bioreactor to prevent mixing with the adjacent groundwater table and to make it, I guess, a little bit more robust. This field has old concrete tile. You can see it behind us here. It's about like 1.5 foot pieces. It's 8-inch diameter tile. We just replaced that older tile with some non-perforated high-density polyethylene pipe, which is standard in the industry these days. And then we install a water control structure in line with that tile outlet. So we've got a water control structure, we hook up that pipe to it, and then we push that water through the pipe into the wood chips. And that's kind of how we control the flow of water, tile water, through the bioreactor. So we can set a different level of water that we want flowing through there. When it comes in, it goes all the way down to the one end, and then it flows back towards the outlet structure, then out to the ditch. And in that time that it takes to flow from one end to the other, the nitrogen gets reduced. And then if we want to completely drain it, we can pull all of the stop logs out and let it completely drain. So it just gives us a little control over how much water is moving through the bioreactor. Naturally, we want as much flowing through there as possible, but it does give us some knobs to turn, so to speak, that we can, you know, control the flow. And if a producer didn't want to continue putting water through the bioreactor, they could just completely open those control structures and let the water flow through.
Then we start backfilling the wood chips in, and then we fill the wood chips to the height that was needed to filter all the tile water. The project that we're working on now required 170 cubic yard, and we got 200 just to be on the safe side because we can always use a little more. When we're looking at the size and the ratio of the small sawdust, we don't want too much of that because that fills in too much of the cracks, where the bigger wood chips, like the 2x2 diameter, is what we're trying to look for because the water can pass through it easier and then it can still filter through and they won't degrade as much. What we put over the wood chips is a thick geotextile material, kind of like landscaping material, but a little thicker, so the small soil particles don't go into the wood chips. So we need that barrier between topsoil and the wood chips. And once we put the geotextile down, then we start filling in over the top with soil.
And then we will seed down the soil on top of the earth, and then it will once again be grass area that we don't want folks to drive on. This site will also be monitored, so follow up on looking at how effective this is will be documented.
We do have a management plan that we do give to producers to optimize the nitrate removal, but knowing that at some points in the year they may need to drain them completely for field operations or some other endeavor, we do give them the option by opening up the lid, and there's a little tool that you can use to pull out the boards, and it's a pretty easy job. Most of the hours in this project are on the front end of designing and coordinating the construction, but it took about 8 hours to install this wood chip bioreactor today. This project has been paid through multiple funding pools. NRCS Minnesota has a cooperative agreement with Ecosystem Services Exchange, and so the NRCS paid for the design of the bioreactor, and the state of Minnesota is paying for the installation. Typically, a bioreactor of about this size, 80 feet long by 20 feet wide, runs about $10,000 to $12,000 to install. The producer didn't have to spend any of their own money for this particular project. As it was, the Soil Water Conservation District in this county was able to come up with a 100% installation cost for him.
I'm the fourth generation of Toquams to farm this land. My grandfather and great-grandfather settled here in 1940. When they came here, none of this land had been farmed before. It was sod and prairie. And so my grandfather helped build this ditch through here, and then them, along with my father, installed drainage tile, which made this soil and our land very productive. And so our family's been very involved with soil conservation. We're very concerned, just like everyone else is, about water quality and nitrates in our water. Removing nitrates and excess fertilizers out of our water that's going into our drainage ditch and into our water systems here in Minnesota, it was very intriguing, and it fit right into our motto and our goals of our farm. This is the home farm right here. My youngest son lives there, and then there's another farm to the south that my middle son lives at, and then another farm to the north that my oldest son lives at. And all three farm with my wife and I. And also, I can't forget my father, 85-year-old father, is here every day.
if you're a producer and you'd like to explore the possibility of installing a bioreactor or a saturated buffer, any of these edge of field denitrifying practices, contact your local NRCS or Soil Water Conservation District office. We'll start by helping you plan that conservation process, and we'll come out and figure out if those practices are a good fit for your location and your management, and if they are, we'll pursue them further through the design process with consideration of the producer's objectives.
The project should last 15 to 20 years. A lot of farmers could do these if they had the space, because one of the things that we don't want to see is any heavy equipment or anything driving over the wood chip bioreactor once it has been filled in with soil over top, because the compaction and it reduces the longevity and the effectiveness if it's compacted down. And it's not something that you want in your way when you're trying to plant or harvest or do any sort of fall tillage.
Tile is the lifeblood of our land. If we didn't have tile, we wouldn't be productive. We wouldn't be able to be profitable out here. So in order for us to be able to continue to tile our land, we have to find ways to work with environmentalists and environmental groups to make sure that the water leaving our land doesn't contain any excess fertilizer. So I believe, yes, this is, if we want to stay in the tiling business and stay farming productive land, we all have to be looking at things like this.